Hey guys, this is Julia, and I have yet another card for you featuring supplies from the new Spellbinders collection. And today I want to show you how you can use subtle backgrounds to enhance really fine details. And with really fine details, I mean this gorgeous die set, the Nordic Blooms Edge Dies by Spellbinders. Absolutely wonderful. So many details that you can create with these dies. I'm absolutely in love with them. I'm also going to be using the large die set of the month from, oh gosh, I think, was it February or March? Not sure, sorry. Because it has this U word die. I'm starting out by gluing some of these die cuts together. I had already prepared them. I had already glued two layers together, and I'm just using my glue pen here to glue the third layer on top, and this gives me a nice dimensional effect. By the way, all my supplies will be listed in the video description below and on my blog. Next, I'm using my VersaFine ink pad, and I'm just smooshing it really against the die cuts so they will the one side of them will become sticky. I mean, if you just let it dry, it's not going to be sticky, but VersaFine is a sticky ink while it's wet. And this actually helps me because I want to put some perfect pearls on top of it. That's just to give them some shine, to make it more interesting, because I don't have any specialty paper. I usually just create stuff myself because that's more versatile than if I would have a whole bunch of paper for that here. Just dabbing on the powder, and you need very little powder. It's almost nothing that you need there. Just dabbing this on because the VersaFine ink will grab it, and once it dries, you will have a really nice effect. So then I'm using a few distress inks, excuse me, a few distress inks to create a nice background. And all I'm doing is I'm blending these inks together. That's all I'm doing, just using a few pinks and a little bit of orange here to create a very subtle, very soft background effect. And it doesn't look perfectly blended yet, but that doesn't matter. Like, don't worry about it too much, because now what I'm doing is I'm coming back and I'm just dipping my finger into my water bowl, which is off to the side, and then I'm dropping some water drops on here. And I'm just, you're watching this in real time. I haven't sped this up in any way. So it's just a few seconds, and then I'm taking a clean cloth or a clean kitchen towel thingy, paper towel thingy, and I'm going to dab this off. And you can see how it starts to react. You can literally watch it happen. This is absolutely real time. I've not sped it up, and now I'm picking up the water, which means I'm also picking up some color. And now suddenly it doesn't matter that I didn't blend it perfectly, because the water drops will create this amazing effect, which will, just create so much more interest and kind of distract from the not perfectly blended background. I really just blended as much as I needed because I needed to have some color there, but that's all that I needed. And of course, I have to finish off by spritzing this entire thing with my mixture of water and perfect pearls. Again, not my idea. I stole that from Jennifer McGuire ages ago, but I think it's just perfect to add some shimmer and shine to your project. Since this is watercolor, I only spritzed it once because I didn't want the color to run. I wanted it to, those blotches to be exactly where they are. I stamped the thinking off, which is part of another stamp set. Again, listing this in the video description below. I had some double-sided adhesive tape on the back of the black die cut here, so I just peeled the backing paper off. Now I can glue down the U, and with these two pieces, dimensional embellishments that I created from the die cuts from Spellbinders, I just put some what is it? Tom, no, it's not Tombow Mono. Glossy accents. I put some glossy accents on the back, but I was very, very careful so I wouldn't put on too much. I was afraid it would squeeze out off to the side, and then you would see it. So I was very, very conservative with that. Then when I had put everything together, I realized that the U wasn't dark enough, so I just used a black marker and very carefully traced it because I really didn't want to accidentally paint on my beautiful background. So I did this very carefully and gently. And finally, to cap it all off, I had to add some Sparkling Clear Sequins by Pretty Pink Posh. You know that those are my absolutely favorite sequins and my favorite sequin color, and I adhered them with some glossy accent. Excellent. So here's a close-up of the dimensional embellishment that I created with the new dies from Spellbinders. I just love it. I love the intricate shape. Here you can see the U die cut. I think I covered it with some Wink of Stella after I was finished recording, I just thought of it then. And here is the finished card. It's a very nice combination of the striking white against the subtle background. I hope you like it. I hope you got inspired and check out the new release by Spellbinders. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comment section, and I would love if you'd subscribe because I've got lots more videos to come. Thank you and see you again soon. Bye bye.